Hello students, morning to you all. Again I am before you with the topic of class 9, coordinate geometry part 2, which is actually a question answer video related to coordinate geometry. In part 1 we have seen the concept related to coordinate geometry of class 9 level. Now on that basis of concepts we are going to answer a few questions which are given in your NCERT exercise. So let us start. Question 1. Classify the following points into different quadrant or on different axis. Also locate them on a Cartesian plane. So students, here you see two works have been asked to perform in the question 1. First is to classify the given points or classify the given coordinates of different points into related quadrant where it does belong, and another work is to locate them on a Cartesian plane on a graph paper. So one by one I am taking. The first point is 3, 1. So you have gone through already. So this point belongs to first quadrant. Very good. Next is -3, 2. So according to concept, x value is negative whereas y is positive. So recall the quadrant concepts, then answer comes second quadrant. Third one point is -2, 0. Again I just want to remind you that recall the concept, that is when one coordinate is 0, you know that point doesn't belong to any quadrant, rather it belongs to axis. So here -2, 0. So y coordinate is 0, so definitely this point belongs to x axis. Next is -4, -2. Its x value is positive, y negative. So recall again, so it goes to fourth quadrant. Next is -1, -4. Both negative, you know both negative belongs to third quadrant. So answer is third quadrant. Next is 0, -1. So x coordinate is 0. So this goes to y-axis. Good. So I think you have learnt in a better way. Now to show the position of this point, or to plot or to locate on a graph paper, that is on Cartesian plane. You know Cartesian plane means we have to take Cartesian axis, two perpendicular lines cutting at one point called origin, and since coordinates are negative also, so we have to take both the part to divide uniformly. Taking a suitable scale, we divide x-axis as well as y-axis as shown in this figure. Okay, so you know first point both values are positive, 3, 1, so it belongs to first quadrant. X value is 3, y value is 1. So take x equal to 3 and goes above, and from y axis we have to take 1, so both these two meets at point, that is the required point 3, 1, which is located here. Next is -3, 2, so x is -3 and y is 2, so see here this one. Next is -2, 0, which is on x axis, so we will search -2 on x axis and y is 0, so point will come on x axis. So I am showing here point is this one. Okay students, now next point is 4, -2. X is 4, that is related to fourth quadrant, so we find x equal to 4, then come down, and from y axis we take -2, so we arrive at this point. So this is the required point. Now next is -1, -4, so x is, both are negative, so it is in third quadrant. So take -1 from x axis and -4 from y axis, they meet at this point. And last one is 0, -2, which is actually x value is 0, so it will belong to y axis, and y value is -2, so search -2 on y axis, that is your required point, so it is here. Okay student, so nicely we have located this point on a Cartesian plane. Okay, now come to second question. Where does the following point lie? Simply we have to give the answer mentioning where it belongs. So first is 2, 0, quite natural, no need I think again and again explaining. Y value is 0, so it will go on x axis. Okay, now the second point is 0, 0, 0, both are 0, so recall you can easily answer that this point is at origin. And next one is 0, 5, since x coordinate is 0, so point goes to y axis. Very good. Now one more question is there, that write a point whose ordinate is -3 and abscissa is 4. So student recall, you know, first we write x value, that is abscissa, and then ordinate y value. So question is given where ordinate has been given first and later on abscissa. So don't write just taking two values, we should think here which one value should come first. So abscissa is 4, ordinate is -3, so point is inside small bracket, we will write 4, -3. So in this way I think this chapter is on class 9 basis. It is really very easy chapter, but it is important too because it introduces the new geometry for 9th class student, and it will go ahead in class 10, 11 and 12, so we must learn in a proper way. And I do hope that you have learned in a very good manner. You are now fully able to solve your NCERT exercise and other book, practice book wagera. Okay, so thanks and have a nice day. We will meet again in the next video. Okay students, so don't forget to शेयर कमेंट लाइक एंड सब्सक्राइब. ओके टिल देन गुड बाय. वी विल मीट इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो. थैंकिंग यू ऑल.